헬로 에브리원, 안녕하십니까? 안녕하세요. 헬로. 베너를 보검스 담마토 in English. So Korean Buddhism. Today I'm talking about Korean shamanism. Shamanism. Korean shamanism. So Korean shamanism. In order to understand Korean Buddhism, it's necessary to understand shamanism, the indigenous religion of Korea. Long history. Korean shamanism has a long history. Shamanism or Shamanism is a religious practice involving practitioners, shaman or shamans, who interact with the spirit world through altered stage of consciousness, such as hypnotism. Its goal is usually to the guide spirit or spiritual energy into the physical world to aid humans in healing, divination, or otherwise. Beliefs and practices classified as shamanic have attracted the attention of scholars from a variety of fields, including anthropologists, ecologists, historians, scholars of religious studies, philosophers, and psychologists. Hundreds of books and academic articles have been produced on the subject, and peer-reviewed journals are devoted to the study of shamanism. In the 20th century, non-native Westerners involved in countercultural movements such as hippies and New Age were influenced by their ideas about the various indigenous religions and created modern magical religious practices, creating what has been called Neo-Shamanism or the Neo-Shamanist movement. It not only influenced the development of many Neo-Pagan practices, but also faced backlash and accusation of cultural appropriation, exploitations, and misrepresentation. And outside, observers attempt to perform or represent rituals of centuries-old cultures to which they did not belong. Etymology of shamanism. The 17th century, Dutch explorer Nicole Wissen described a Siberian shaman in Russia, Siberian shaman. Wissen called him the devil's priest and drew cloth pit, supposedly demonic traits. The modern English word shamanism is derived from the Russian shaman, itself derived from the Tungus word shaman. It probably derives from the southwestern dialect of Evenki or Manchu language spoken by the Shin Evenki peoples. The word's etymology is sometimes connected with the Dangun's root, sa, meaning to know. Sa means to know. However, Finnish anthropologist Juba Jahonen questioned that connection on the linguistic ground. There is no single agreed upon definition of the word shamanism among the anthropologists. Thomas Nansen proposed three shared elements of shamanism. Practitioners continuously alter rituals. The continuity regards ritual as an important ritual practice, and knowledge of the practice is controlled. British historian Ronald Hutton noted that there are four separate definitions of the term that appear to be in use at the beginning of the 21st century. The first of these uses the term to refer to anyone who comes into contact with the spirit world while in an altered state of consciousness. The second definition restricts the term to those who came into contact with the spirit world while in an altered state of consciousness at the request of others. So I'm talking about now shamanism because if you want to understand Korean Buddhism, what the Korean Buddhism is real, in reality. So previous lectures, I mentioned you must understand Sangguk-yoksa and Sangguk-sagi and Three Kingdoms, whatever. But also, you should have knowledge about shamanism. Otherwise, it's very difficult to understand what Korean Buddhism is really. So, first of all, we should understand what shamanism is. That's why I'm talking about. The third definition attempt to distinguish a shaman from other magical religious practitioners believed to be in contact with spirit such as mediums, shamans, spiritual healers or seers. Scholars advocating the third view disagree what the definition description should be. The fourth definition identified by Hutton uses shamanism to refer to indigenous religions of Siberia and neighboring regions of Asia. According to the Golm Center for Shamanic Studies, a Mongolian shaman organization, the event word shaman would be more accurately translated as priest. So, well, I think it's a quite difficult subject to talk about the shamanism, but if you understand Korean Buddhism, somehow you should have some knowledge about shamanism. Otherwise, you cannot know Korean Buddhism exactly. That's why we know about what the shamanism is, what the shamanism in Korea. That's why I introduced. So, I don't know whether you understand what I'm talking about. So far, I had five lectures. So, I will introduce not only ancient time of, I mean, the Buddhism in ancient time in Korea, but also modern time also. I'd like to introduce. Thank you very much for listening to my Dhamma talk, my class, my lecture. Thank you very much. 감사합니다. See you again.